Check out our sneak peek into our Sisters in Business Expo in Philly.
We use tea as a means to relax our guests, warm their hearts, and open their minds to new possibilities. Get your China teacups and enjoy the show.
Hey, 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 it's your girl, Lady T. My daughter and I went out to the Sisters in Business Expo in Philly. It was a wonderful event, so check it out.
I know that we as African-American women, we're like, oh, it's always, you know, you don't feel like you can have an African-American mentor. I've been blessed. Everywhere I talk, I can't get rid of them. They everywhere for me. Every job I've ever had, every educational experience I've ever had, every position that I've ever been placed in, there has been an African-American woman that literally tapped me on the shoulder and said, I think you're pretty cool. And I got some knowledge to share with you. I'm gonna hip you to some game. I'm gonna give you this so you can go on to the next part of your journey. I never had to look for mentorship. It was always there. So I'm always in turn looking for other people to mentor. When I wanted to write a book, there was somebody to tell me how to write the book, so I wrote the book. Then years later, there were sisters that wanted to write books, so I held a forum on this is how you self-publish yourself. You know, you have to look for the mentorship and understand there's a cost to it. They may not be charging you for the mentorship, but there's a responsibility in turn because you're not entitled to keep that information to yourself. There's room for everybody. There's room for everybody. What Allah or God has made for you is not going to miss you. So there's no point in trying to block somebody else. So make sure you share everything that you have.
Supply store. Not only are we black owned, we go out and we seek individuals who are women of color who make their own natural and skin products, natural hair and skin products. The reason being is that we believe that what the Koreans have done, huge shout out to them because they have really allowed us to open our business with a purpose. And the purpose is to make sure that chemicals do not affect our hair anymore. We are done with so many people walking into our store and actually are going bald because they believe that the product that they're using is safe. We are educating individuals when they walk into the store. We give them all the information they need. We bring in a number of individuals from Africa all the way to the United States, products sit on our shelves. And so we expose them, I interview them in the store so that you can see that they need to shine just as much as Dark and Lovely have their commercials, but it's killing our hair. So that's who we are as a business. I asked my husband the other night, what would be my superpower name? Because I always feel like superheroes are named, some people name you. You know what I mean? Sometimes it doesn't come from you. Some people just name you. And so he says, well, why don't your name be Chocolate Goddess, what I've called you all these years. So wonderful. My superhero name is Chocolate Goddess. I'm better recognized.
Like-minded people. I'm sorry, you gotta get off that block. You gotta get off that corner. You gotta get off the phone and stop gossiping. Don't call me about your baby daddy. Don't call me about your husband. I don't have a husband. I don't have a baby daddy, so we don't have relations in terms of that. People talk about fees. If you've been in business for 5 years or more, you should not be giving free consultations. And I'm gonna do that right there.
No, that's right. To ask a few questions, connect with you, and then see where it goes from there. And so I set parameters with our relationship. So I said to her after the first 30 minutes, I was like, okay, now as much as she's interviewing me, I'm interviewing her because what I see on social media may not be exactly who she is. And so I'm interviewing, I think, oh, this is a good feel. So every month for 1 hour, we get on the phone and I ask her all the questions I have for that month.
Myself at the time and said, listen, you don't even know how fabulous you are. Let me give you these few things that you can take on your next journey. So when I was looking to even match up those mentors with other people, what I was looking was for people that were already open. You know, you shouldn't have to beg someone to be your mentor. You know, they already should already have that kind of character and personality where they want to assist someone else.
How do I make sure that my time actually allows me to do that? With the help of my husband, who is he's my rock, my partner. He will say, well then you need to do this so that you can complete it. Because what the last thing you don't want to do, you don't want to be somebody who starts something and never finish it. Nobody wants that. You always want to complete the project you have and build it up to fruition. So for me, time management, literally dressing out, okay, if I'm going to be an author, I'm going to spend 9 months and not focus on but so much but that. And that, work on the next project that you want to do, and then get advice. Let me explain. In order for you to really understand how you're going to do things in life is understanding how time management works. I took classes on that. Because I just can't wake up and go, I'm gonna do A, B, and C. I may fail someone because I might forget. I need to understand what time management is. So for me, it is important for you to understand to get with someone who can help you with that, and also really find someone who's going to mentor you through it. Someone who knows what you want to do. So that's the biggest advice that worked for me in order for me to do a lot of things. And also what helps, I don't have children. So I know that's very difficult having children. So I'm a little bit more open to running out and doing all the things that I want to do because I don't have that extra. But still, even if you do have children, time management is going to help you with your children as well.
I mean, they're not exactly a whole tax bracket above you. You know, but they may be a few positions above you and have that experience and be able to assist you. It's not always the CEO. It's not always that person with a title. And I learned that from Paris Nicole. Literally a week ago, we connected on Instagram and then on social media, and she was, someone needed a publicist and tagged us and some other folks. And we were talking, I said, well, listen, this is her expertise, and you may want to go with this person, that person. But we begin to talk, and we begin to inbox about fee schedules. And she was schooling me. I was like, oh, no. I'm underpaying myself. I got to get paid. So that person that's in your industry that knows just a little bit more can give you the most mentorship.